بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear beautiful people, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Someone asked, why do I call you beautiful people when some of us are not beautiful? I agree, some of us are not beautiful, but what I mean is the beauty inside you. I don't care where you are today, but I'm looking at the future where you are going to be someday. You are going to reach a stage where you are actually beautiful in the internal, just like you are in the external, so to speak. So I call it beautiful. That is a kind of also of a dua that Allah makes you beautiful. My today's pep talk is about something that we Muslims today lack great deal. And that's something there, subhanAllah, the rest of the world has it, except us. What is that something there? Notice, well, as soon as I say it, you're going to say, ha, honesty. And I don't mean honesty in speaking the truth, because a lot of Muslims today consider when they speak the truth as the exception. Lying is the norm. So when someone is actually truthful to you, you kind of like, mashallah, they spoke the truth. Wallahi ajeeb. Just like when you lend money to somebody and they agree to give it to you in 2 weeks' time, and then in 2 weeks' time they come with the money. Aren't you surprised? Because the expectations today is when you donate money to somebody, you just need to wave it. Assalamu alaikum, see you on the qiyamah. As-saraha, honesty. Honesty with each other. Something that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught to us, sahaba. And the sahaba were honest with each other. They never, ever sugar-coated anything, or honey-coated it, or just all these big titles, brother, mashallah, and they said something as it was. One day, a man came to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu anhu, very angry. When Abu Bakr became Khalifa Rasulullah, the Khalifa, he appointed Umar as the judge. The judge meaning like the district judge or the country judge. Anyone who has a problem, let him go to Umar ibn al-Khattab. He is the judge who's going to rule between people. For the 2 years, I think a year and a half, nobody went to Umar. Everybody was fine. Nobody had a trouble. Umar resigned from the post. And he goes, I am unemployed. I am there and I do absolutely nothing. Nobody comes and nobody complains. Everybody is happy with each other. I wonder if Umar ibn al-Khattab was today amongst us, what kind of complaints we'll take to them. But anyway, what I'm on about today is honesty. Honesty in behavior, honesty in the speech, honesty in the brotherhood, honesty in the friendship. If you asked me honestly, how many people can I rely on as my friends? I would count them not on my fingers. I will count them on one finger, on I would say the top of the finger and maybe one of the bottom. I don't know about the third one. Look at yourself. If you had an emergency, who would you call? If you have like a selection of 10 people, you brace yourself and you really, really be thankful to Allah and make sure you keep these people. If you have a problem, who would you go to confine in? It's a difficult question, really, really difficult. A lot of our problems these days are because we don't have anyone to confine in. You have a problem with your husband, who are you going to turn to that you feel safe, that your secret with them is going to remain secret, that they're not going to use it against you someday, that they're not going to turn the gun spiral right around your head. It's very difficult, very, very difficult. A lot of people also confuse honesty with arrogance. They confuse the two. They are honest, but they do it in such a way that you go, subhanAllah, what's wrong with these people? Why are they like this? So where do we draw the line? Where do we draw the line? Look at this beautiful hadith in al-Bukhari. One day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed dhuhr or asr. There are two narrations. And for rak'at, and in the Bukhari, this one, he had 4 rak'at, and then he prayed 2 rak'at, and then he said, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. The narrator of the hadith says, فَخَرَجَ السُّرَّعَ. As-surra' are the people who are always quick to leave, the hurry ones, the hasty. Pay attention. even at the time of Rasulullah, there were people who couldn't wait 1 second in the masjid. As-surra. So as soon as he said, Assalamu alaikum, these people stood and left. That has always been that case. And the Sahaba remained sitting looking at Rasulullah. Remember, and I will say it again, the Sahaba's look at the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, Allah put the man on how Allah wants to be worshipped. And he said, I want to be worshipped just like Muhammad does. So you look at him, whatever he does, you do it. That's how they understood it. So when he prayed Dhuhr, 2 rak'at, they kept looking what it is that he is going to do. The people who in a hurry left yelling, As-salat has been shortened. What a problem. They did it. Rasulullah is there. They didn't even care asking. They are that kind of people. A man called Dhulyadain. Dhulyadain, he had long arms. Stood up and he said to Rasulullah, look at the honesty, he said. Ya Rasulullah, has the salat been shortened or did you forget? Rasulullah didn't answer back to him. He stood up by his minbar, entwining his fingers and looking. And the man said, Ya Rasulullah, has the salat been shortened or have you forgotten? Rasulullah looks at him and then he looks at the sahaba and he said to them, is what your friend, your brother says, is that true or not? They said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, what he spoke is the truth. I.e., Rasulullah prayed 2 rak'at. So Rasulullah looks at the man and he said like this to him, it's neither this nor the other. The salat has not been forgotten, and I have not been shortened, and I have not forgotten. This narration is in Al-Bukhari. It says, now the man said, no, Ya Rasulullah, you have forgotten. This is not true, even if it's in Al-Bukhari. The Sahaba would never, ever belie Rasulullah. Rasulullah says, I have not forgotten and it has not been shortened. And the man says, no, you have forgotten. That means you are lying. Na'udhu billah that the Sahabi says that. And this is one of the things that the scholars have rejected from Sahih al-Bukhari as well. Look at the honesty of Rasulullah. He didn't go around the corner and beat around the bush. I have not forgotten and the salat has not been shortened. And then he turned and prayed 2 rak'at and then made the sujood, a saw and end of it. Today, my brothers and my sisters, we live in a judgmental world where you are judged by everything. People lie to each other. They say things they don't mean. A lot of people call you my brother. Well, in his heart, it's just a title. He doesn't mean it. That's a lie. It's a sin against you. When Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً in Al-Quran, He meant the interactivity. We share the belief and we share also the faith and the interaction. Not words that come to mouth. It's very sad reality. So honesty, for instance, you have a sister or brother or whatever it is, the title that these things. And I agree, and this happens to me a lot. I make an appointment to someone to meet them at 10 o'clock. I'm always there at 9:45, 9:50, and I sit in a corner. If it's in a cafe, I sit in a cafe. If it's outside, I sit in a corner. And I always take with me something to read, just to make sure that I am on time. Then the person comes late. That infuriates me. And now I am in a very sticky situation. Do I tell him, or do I just bite the dust and keep quiet? Well, I usually tell people. I tell them, look, I've been here from 10 to 10 just to make sure I'm on time because I respect you and I respect my time and I respect myself. Then they go on in a frenzy, giving me every excuse as to why they are late. And to tell you the truth, my brothers and my sisters, today anyone who gives me an excuse to me is a liar. I don't take excuses. I don't accept them at all. And if you have listened to my pep talk about excusitis, I don't take excuses at all, especially in appointments. So if you are in a situation where someone has wronged you, do tell them. Be honest. And if you have been wronged, be honest. Say it nicely, sugarcoat it, do whatever. We live in dodgy times today where people are so touchy. If you tell someone, Ya akhi, wallahi, you made me wait, I've wasted 15 minutes. They get touchy. What is 15? And then they start justifying, why should you be annoyed with me? Wrong. I have every right to be annoyed with you because you came late and Al-Islam has labeled you as a hypocrite. And this is the actions hypocrite, not the belief hypocrisy. So if someone, for example, tells you, can you keep my kids? I would just go there for 5 minutes and be right back. So you do your plans for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, half an hour. And then the person goes and takes the liberty and takes 3 hours, 2 hours, 1 hour. They don't even bother giving you a call to say, I'm late or something. And then they come and they expect you to accommodate their nonsense, their very unfriendly behavior. And if you talk to them, they will pull their nose up and stop talking to you and they will stop treating you nicely. Don't you guys think we have got a problem here? We do. A man went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq to complain about Umar. Because the man went to Abu Bakr and he told him about a situation, and Abu Bakr told him, go and see Umar. And the man went and saw Umar, and Umar was telling the guy what should be done. This man goes back to Abu Bakr and he goes, who is Khalifa here? Are you the Khalifa or is he the Khalifa? Do you think, what did Abu Bakr say? He didn't say, what did he say? Why? No, he said, well, if he wants to be the Khalifa, I'm happy with that. This is why these people were the companion of a prophet, not me, not you. Because we would suck, big deal. The hypocrisy is up to our teeth. Imagine if Rasulullah was today amongst us, in the masjid. Every time somebody walks into the masjid, they would go to him and kiss his feet and pretend to love him and pretend, I love you to bits, Ya Rasulullah. I would give anything about you, to you, to save, to do. Oh, just say it. Just raise your finger, Ya Rasulullah, and I'll be here and there and then. You are a liar. Because Rasulullah is dead in the physique, but he is still alive in the sunnah. Why when I tell you Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, do this and do that, you show me your back? Why when I tell you, do this because Rasulullah ﷺ said that, you stick your middle finger at me, you don't care at all? Why when I tell you Allah does this, you don't even look at me, you think like, who am I to tell you? Well, that's why you don't deserve to be part of the great nation that was the Sahaba of Rasulullah. So from now on, my brothers and my sisters, enough hypocrisy, enough rubbing coats, enough kissing bombs, enough of this stuff. Be good with people. I would love when someone is honest with me. Abu Hanifa, you must stop there. And me, I love it. I go, Jazakallah khair, end of it. I must stop, I apologize, move on. As opposed to, I have to watch myself what I say with you. I live on a microscope just to make sure I haven't done anything wrong. No. Please, for the love of Allah, let's be honest. Let's stop being hypocrite. And let's be human. Let's be real Muslims. We can't have 600 faces. Okay, bro, I'll see you later, bro. It used to be brother, now it's bro. And it used to be sister, now it's sis. Only Allah knows one day it's going to be, hey, B, how are you doing? Hey, S, how are you doing? La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. I pray to Allah to take us back to him in the best of terms. Muslims are funny these days. They are the worst example that you can give to somebody to tell them how to be good. At one point, we used to give Muslims as an example of how goodness should be. Today, if you want to show how evil you can be, pinpoint to a Muslim and you won't be wrong. You, my brother, keep working at becoming the best of who you can be and do what's best to make you the best, and be the best to do what's best for you. Because one day, you will want to do something best, and that day is too late, you'll be dead. I pray to Allah Tabarakata to give us the honesty in interacting with people, in honesty in loving, honesty in everything. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad, subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother, Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. 078-7640-8735. If you want to join my group, or if you have a comment, or you want to buy me flowers or throw me rocks, that's my number. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.